I'm all ears. Who wants to start?
I would tell you a tale of treachery. A story of how knowing and unknowing...
I will hear you out.
Stories, like blades, have to be balanced and honed. You must remember, it is almost as easy to cut yourself as your target if you are not careful.
Back to riddles. If all talked like council, nothing would get done.
Words, my friend, can be the deadliest weapon. A carefully placed whisper here, or a loose tongue at the right table. Wars can be won and lost with the true victor never even landing a blow.
Such as the Blades of Erebos?
Very good, my lord. But the Blades were never afraid of getting their hands dirty when needed.
I would hear more of them than the rumors that swirl in fireside tales. Tell me the truth of them, Jorgen.
Well, as we are learning from history, or what passes for it in some places, let me tell you of the Blades of Erebos. 575, a fine year for fine wines, though the Aegean Peninsula is not particularly known for its grapes. But it was there and then that the Blade's existence came to light. You've all heard of the Twilight Covenant. The end of the Elder Wars after decades of death and destruction. But Erebos, the master of assassins, believed only in shadow and conflict. The Faceless knew they could not contain him, for Erebos was with death, as a drunk is to wine, so they sealed him away forever. Or so they thought. With freedom, Erebos needed like-minded souls on his quest for vengeance, and the elf Salvin's pain called to him. So Erebos took him and his two disciples, Vyron and Malwen. Malwen was as a daughter to Salvin. And it's true, she thought she was of his blood. While Vyron was hungry with a fanaticism born from youth, a more than willing disciple to the cause. With these disparate souls were forged the Blades of Erebos.
There is much work to be done, and I fear we are too few. Seek out Agit of the Black Fang. The Thieves' Guild will profit greatly from our work here.
So it's only right they share the burden of labor.
Brother, you would have everyone at each other's throats.
Why risk our own people when others can so easily be persuaded to do our bidding without a mention of us on their lips? These are lessons you two should learn well. Now, we have much to discuss. We find ourselves amongst an abundance of unenlightened foes. Orcs, wizards, and elves all jockeying for position to claim the peninsula.
It will be a simple task to have them each baying for the other's blood.
True, but there is still much to be done to ensure success. Go now and meet with Agit. Plant the seeds of suspicion. And let the fire of vengeance burn amongst our enemies. Let them tear themselves apart.
Thank you. Thank you.